Look, Hikaru and QVC.
What's the idea here? Mr. Monkey.
Bing, bang, boom. 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 Bing, bang, boom.
Cat for sculptures.
Spam this flower to give Hikaru power.
Nakamura, Nakamura. Nakamura, Nakamura. Nakamura, Nakamura.
Oh, Nakamura.
Nakamura, Nakamura.
Chess is a game for everyone.
A very accurate statement.
Elitism in chess.
Ignores the haters.
Nakamura, Nakamura. Nakamura, Nakamura. Nakamura, Nakamura.
Oh, Nakamura.
Nakamura, Nakamura.
Chess is the ultimate game. It's just the best.
It's for the community.
A new boom for chess.
Wow. That is awesome.
Negative talent in life.
Chess is a wonderful game. Try it, enjoy it, and you'll see that it's just awesome.
Welcome to the grandest stage of them all. WrestleMania! Everybody, Samay OP in the chat. Supreme Leader has arrived, guys. Supreme Leader Samay OP in the chat. Thank you. आज हम लड़ने जा रहे हैं, आज हम वो काम करने जा रहे हैं जिससे हम दुनिया में नाम करेंगे. हमने ऑलरेडी दुनिया में काफी नाम किया है, बट दिस शुड बी द फाइनल नेल इन द कॉफिन. एवरी अचीवमेंट अंटिल नाउ इज नथिंग इन कंपैरिजन टू दिस. माई वीडियो ऑन अकेडमी डस्ट चैनल, me getting checkmated by Magnus Carlsen, everything. ये अगर हमने आज नहीं किया दोस्तों, तो कोई फायदा नहीं उस सबका भाई. आज हमें जीतना है भाई, आज हमें हगना नहीं है भाई. तो सबसे पहले आते हैं फटाफट अपने मेंबर्स के पास. बहन बहुत कहां हो भाइयों? हेलो,
यो यो यो
है, यो 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 क्या एनर्जी किधर है? वेरी एनर्जी एनर्जी मांगता है आज. व्हाट आर बी स्टैट्स?
एनर्जी है भाई. Supreme Leader, भाई Supreme Leader,
समय ओपी, नो भाई है,
समय ओपी.
दोस्तों तुम्हारी गाइस, आज मैंने सबसे एक-एक फोटो मंगाई उनकी. इतनी अश्लील फोटो है मेरे पास, सारी इतनी गंदी फोटो है. अगर तुम में से एक भी हारा भाई हो, आज तुम्हारी नंगी नंगी फोटो मैं लीक करूंगा भाई, पूरी दुनिया देखेगी. द वर्ल्ड विल वॉच. नो प्रेशर
बट फुल प्रेशर
भाई. बी स्टार्ट, तुझे याद है तूने परसों मेरे को पूछा था कॉल करके, समय भाई मैं अपने बुलेट चेस इन्विटेशनल की स्ट्रीम अपने चैनल पे रिएक्ट कर दूं? मैंने क्या कहा था?
कर दो भाई.
वो क्यों कहा था मैंने कर दो भाई?
ताकि आप स्ट्राइक दे सको,
ताकि मैं आज तुझे को स्ट्राइक मारूं. अगर तूने आज हगा भाई, अगर हमारी टीम ने आज हगा ना भाई, मैं डिस्कॉर्ड में न्यूक कर दूंगा बेंचो. मां चुदा अपना डिस्कॉर्ड भाई, जान मार दूंगा तुम सबकी. ठीक है भाई,
हारेंगे नहीं भाई, जीतेंगे.
डर तो नहीं रहा
भाई, जोश
भाई पेल देंगे भाई.
कोई डर तो नहीं रहना भाई, ये बताओ.
नहीं भाई,
डरो भाई, डरो मुझसे, डरो भाई. आज हमें जीतना है भाई, प्लीज आज डरो भाई, प्लीज. सुप्रीम लीडर इज बेगिंग फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम इन लाइफ, ही सुप्रीम लीडर इज रिक्वेस्टिंग. भाइयों आज मैं बहुत नर्वस हूँ पहले ही. ठीक है भाई, आज तुम्हें कुछ ऐसा करिश्मा कर दिखाना है कि दुनिया याद रखे हमको यार. कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ता अभी तक जो हमने किया, उसका कोई पॉइंट ही नहीं अगर हमने आज नहीं ये किया तो.
आज तो जीतेंगे भाई. Everyone is
भाई.
कहते ना all is well that end is well.
Yes.
तो तुम सबको कुएं में फेंक दूंगा बेंचो, your end will become well. मैं बोलूंगा your end is well, all is well now. समझ रहे हो तुम? गांडे फाड़ दूंगा मैं अगर हारे आज.
टाइम से रहेंगे भाई, टाइम से रहेंगे.
भाई कौन है लो रेटेड प्लेयर? कौन है? हेलो बोलो.
हेलो.
तो आज भी तुमने देखा ओपोनेंट के पास टाइम कम है, क्या करना है?
फ्लैग
क्या करना है?
चेक
कैप्चर बिशप्स. ठीक है भाई,
हां
पेल दूंगा मैं भाई. आई एम जस्ट वेटिंग फॉर द लिंक टू कम. अगर तुम लेकिन आ जा रहे ना, मम्मी कसम, कसम मेरी माँ की भाई, मैं सबको सर्वर बैन दे दूंगा. जो हारा सर्वर बैन. और अगर तुम नहीं हारे आज, तो जब अगली बार हारोगे तब सर्वर बैन भाई. ठीक है, ये एक्सपेक्ट मत करना कि भाई जीत गए तो गिफ्ट मिलेगा. कुछ नहीं मिलेगा तुम्हें.
ये तो भाई लूज लूज सिचुएशन हुई.
लूज कौन बोला ये? कौन बोला ये?
भाई विन. सॉरी सुप्रीम लीडर.
ऑलराइट, हिकारू
सुप्रीम लीडर.
भाई 2 मिनट रुके भाई, थोड़ा अपने को अभी नींद से उठे हम, थोड़ा थोड़ा मूड में तो आए हम। एक सेकंड, मेरी आवाज कम हो रही होगी। एक सेकंड।
गुड मॉर्निंग सुप्रीम लीडर।
यू थैंक यू वेलकम। एडवांस ऑडियो प्रॉपर्टी, माइक की आवाज बढ़ाओ भाई। आवाज सही आ रही है तुम लोगों?
परफेक्ट। हां भाई,
हां परफेक्ट आवाज आ रही है।
आज अगर हारे भाई मैं तुम्हारी चाइल्ड मैरिज करा दूंगा यार।
करा दो भाई, करा दो।
ये कौन है भाई? करा दो भाई, करा दो। ये कौन है भाई?
मनीष साबरा।
ए भाई
भाई
मनीष शावरा। चलो भाई, मनीष की रेटिंग की जगह कुछ और ले आया, ले आ तू। चलो
सुप्रीमीटर में रेटिंग बड़ा चढ़ गया है भाई।
भाइयों सॉरी बोलो सब लोग मिलके।
सॉरी सुप्रीमीटर,
सॉरी सुप्रीमीटर।
गलती तुम बाद में करने वाले हो मुझे पता है। ठीक है चलो, मैं जा रहा हूं अभी। ठीक है, जा रहा हूं मैं भाई। ऑलराइट भाई,
बाय
बाय, लेट्स गो, आई विल बी बैक। कोई डरना मत भाई, इट्स फाइन। लेकिन मैं गांड फाड़ दूंगा तुम्हारे। ऑलराइट, उफ। All right, guys, the link is in the Twitter. I can see it now. All right, guys. दोस्तों ढेर सारा प्यार दीजिएगा। मैं आया just एक सेकंड में। यार उस पे सागर शाह लिखा रहेगा यार, shit. Okay, I'm in the meeting room. Hello. प्लीज उनको बोल दिया जाए, दूसरे सुप्रीम लीडर को जी, कि हम आ चुके हैं मीटिंग रूम में। ओ माय गॉड। ऑलराइट,
लेट मी एडजस्ट माय कैमरास।
हे,
हाउ इज इट गोइंग?
ऑल इज वेल, ऑल इज वेल। हाउ आर यू?
वेरी गुड। या गो अहेड।
सो एक्साइटेड टू मीट यू मैन, फर्स्ट थिंग्स फर्स्ट, बिग फैन एंड वेरी वेरी एक्साइटेड टू बी अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस मैन।
Oh, no problem. It's great to have you on. It's been a long time in the making.
Yeah. And you woke up so early today, and I also woke up so early. It's like we are both morning today.
Yeah, I'm always a morning person generally. I don't know if that's good or not.
Yeah.
So but in my chat they said you go to bed at 8 a.m. in the morning.
Yeah, I go to bed I went to bed at 12. I was actually very anxious today. I was picking up my subs and I didn't want them to, you know, I wanted them to be of top quality, so I picked everybody one by one because this sub battle means a lot to me, man.
No, of course. I heard you're gonna be banning some of your people, right?
No, that's badly. Not true. Who said this? Can you please tell me the username?
Oh, that's just in my chat. I saw many people say it. If many people in chat say it's true, then it has to be true. So I don't know. Maybe you can ban all of them because they probably were watching your show.
No, it's just a language difference, right? So I was talking in Hindi, so it's like it gets lost in translation. That's all.
Right, of course. No, I mean that makes perfect sense, obviously.
You know, it's like Hikaru, first things first, guys, in the chat, Hikaru and all these guys just raised so much money for charity in India. There were, I don't know how many $1,000 were there, Hikaru, if you can tell me.
It was around, I think it was around $455,000 US. So wow. I don't know what that converts to, but
same here, brother. I have, my math is weak. It just multiplied by 70, guys, and let me know in chat. It's a lot of money. So thank you so much for that. Hikaru OP in my chat, please. And second of all, Hikaru, man, I'm such a big fan. Like, I messaged you that I hope that I won't start fanboying around you too much today. And the thing is,
it's all good.
It's like when your idols become your rivals. And that is what it is right now. Today, you are my idol, but today you're also my rival. So I'm not going to go easy on you. I have something prepared for you.
Well, yeah, I mean, but really what it comes down to is whether you motivated your subscribers enough. If that ban, if the preparation with like the banning actually works, and that motivates them.
No,
we will see. We'll see how good of a motivator you are.
I only shower them with love. I speak to them. I ask, what is your problem? Then I solve them. You know, it's like very healthy relationship I have, one-on-one. You know, I go on dates with my friends. Not like that. Like, you know, just a lunch date. Not like that, Marikaru. Mm. Please don't cancel me.
Okay. Yes. Yes. Language differences. Yes. Exactly.
So, Hikaru, whenever you're ready, I have a little surprise for you. Like always.
Right. Yeah. I had some idea about this. You brought in a ringer. You brought in Nihal, right?
What? How do you know this?
Oh, because everyone in chat said that.
Oh,
I mean, your fans, like they aren't loyal enough to you. They take everything you say and they tell me.
If chat knows everything, can chat tell me, is Matic going to go up or not? Because I've invested a little bit there also. Chat seems to know everything, man. But all right. Yeah. So you're going to be playing against Nihal Sareen. So mm-hmm. Nihal recently did a lot of practice matches with me, so I'm sure he's in his best element.
Yeah, I was gonna say one of the things that's amazing is how many talented young junior players there are. You know, there's Nihal, there's like Gukesh, there's Pragnananta, of course, and there's also Raunak as well, Sadwani. So there's so many talented junior players. And I was gonna say, how much of this do you think is because of what Vichy has done over the last, I guess now it's like 30 years even. I mean, do you think it's all his, like all the credit goes to him for this, like this whole big wave?
I'm sure, like, you know, there was this graph that was shown on ChessBase India, mm-hmm. where they show that how many GMs came right after, you know, when Vichy came. So Vichy inspired a lot of people. In fact, like, he was in our books. Everyone knew about him. Before we knew how to play chess, we knew that, okay, Vishwanathan Anand is the world champion. So it was taught to us. He was, he's just like a phenom, you know, he's like the Undertaker of Indian chess. He's one of the legends.
Right, right.
So for sure, he has had the maximum impact on chess. And yeah, you know, I also got to play with him. And what he said to me was that thanks to somebody, chess has become a complete joke.
That's what he said? Wow, yeah. Okay.
So he's a very funny guy also.
Amazing. So how do you want me to start off against Nihal, or do we start at the bottom and then go to the top? Which order do you want to do?
We'll start from the top, then we go to the bottom.
Mm-hmm. Okay, perfect.
You know, like, so that's how I like it, and mm-hmm. No pun intended. And
right. Yeah, as soon as you said that, I think you'll probably saw my eyebrows change a little bit there. But anyway, yeah.
But to decide who gets white pieces, Hikaru. Since I'm a comedian, I used to be a comedian. Then someone mm-hmm. ate a bat. But when I was a comedian, I used to play this improv game called Questions Only. Mm-hmm. All right, so I want to play that game with you to decide who sure. gets white in the first round.
Okay.
The game is simple. We both get a location from the chat. It can be anywhere. It can be a funeral. It can be a wedding. And then we have to just ask each other questions. The first person to not ask a question loses.
To not ask a question?
We just have to ask a question. That's all.
Oh, okay. Okay. Let's go. All right. Okay.
So can we get a location from Hikaru's chat, please? Any location.
Okay. Okay, so when they write the location, I ask you a question about it.
No, you can
right?
just tell me the location, and then we are both in that location.
Oh, okay. I'll say toilet.
Toilet, okay. Man, can you stand a little bit to the left?
Can you stop being in my way?
Are you Mr. Hikaru Nakamura?
Why are you asking my name? We're in the toilet. That's just weird.
Do you know who I am?
I don't know who you are. Who am I?
Do you know Fide?
What is Fide?
Are you into chess?
Why are you asking me questions about my personal life in the toilet? Are you trying to hit on me?
Are you single as well?
Okay. All right, you win. Okay.
So that's, we get white much. Pieces. We get white pieces against Hikaru in the first match. Let's go.
Okay. All right.
Just some toilet humor, guys.
Yes. No, that was good. That was good. Wow. Okay. All right. Okay. So, yeah. So, I guess they'll start the game then.
Yeah.
I don't mind talking during the game, so it's completely fine.
Yes. That's cool.
Yeah, I've actually, like, I spent some time in Canada when I was younger in the city called Vancouver. And, like, there are a lot of people who are, like, doing improv and these sorts of things. And I remember going to, like, an improv theater to watch them just do these random skits. So it's always been something that I've kind of found amazing, how people on the fly, they can come up with all these questions and just these random topics where it's, like, you go and you ask the audience, like, you know, say you're somewhere, and then they create this whole dialogue and go from there. So it's pretty amazing. Yeah, I find it to be a lot of fun.
Improv is like too much fun also. Like, we made all these grandmasters, Vidit and all, do stand up also in the pandemic and all. Mm-hmm. So it's like a great crossover between comedians and chess players right now.
Right. Yeah, no, I've seen like Vidit's pretty good. Of course Anish can be.
Anish is the funniest man, hands down. Anish gives me insecurity sometimes.
Yeah, although apparently my chat is saying Anish is busy getting checkmate in his game. So I am going to take a very quick look at that before we start.
Oh, damn.
That's what I was told. Said he's getting checkmated.
You know, this is what I was thinking. This mm-hmm. thing that's happening is classical chess, right? So mm-hmm. I was thinking not many people are watching it. Like, as many people watch Rapid, there was like 10,000, 12,000, 13,000 people watching Rapid chess. I couldn't see the same for classical. So I hope, you know, over the time, classical doesn't cease to exist. Because, you know.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I mean, I like classical chess for like certain things, but it's very hard for the audience, I think, because, you know, I guess it's like, I'm trying to think about, like, you know, of course there's a cricket comparison. I guess I don't know why
best the cricket and 2020, right?
But right, but it's like, I mean, I guess like you kind of you but the thing with cricket though, isn't there, there's still always a winner. I mean, that's kind of the thing. Like, and I feel like in a way that's the problem with chess, is because you have draws, no matter how well the players play, that's always an issue.
Yeah. And it's like they take so long to move, no? And then that's how it's supposed to be played. And as an audience, you can't just sit there and watch, you know. I would rather see the analysis on some channel later. And, you know, I was just thinking from a completely brand point of view, you know, that brand wants to... So many brands are now endorsing so many rapid games. And that's...
Right. Yeah, because, I mean, people... I feel like if people watch chess, about the upper limit is like 1 hour. I think people will watch chess for 1 hour, but more than 1 hour, I think it already is kind of a bit much.
Are you already playing?
Also, we are playing, by the way.
Oh, wow. Wait.
Yeah.
I had no idea. How are you such a smooth talker while playing, man? What is your ID?
I usually do that when I stream.
What's your chess.com ID?
Hikaru. Hikaru.
Okay. All right, guys. We can follow Hikaru's game right now. Let me just take you through the game. Something happened, and now we are on 13 move.
Yeah, it's a very much kind of a position that you would not like, because I violated some of the basic rules.
All right, okay. I can only see the bar. That's all I can see.
Ah, yes, the legendary bar. Yeah. The bar is important.
Bar is the most important, I think, for, you know, people like me.
Mm-hmm. No, I think the bar is it is pretty important. So it's how I think kind of people can track the game. Let's see, what am I doing here? This is actually not so great for me. Kind of tricky. Go that way. I can also do that. Do something dubious. Let's see if this works.
Oh, damn. That's a long castle.
Yeah, it's kind of dubious. It's probably not a good decision by me, but we'll see. I'm going to try to create something very complicated.
Yeah, this is very complicated for me. Trust me, man. This is so complicated. I can't understand anything. I can only see that bar is favoring me.
Yes. Yeah, I mean, this is the thing, actually, that's very tricky, though, I think, with chess, is that there are a lot of positions like this where the bar favors one side, but it can also, because if the position is very complicated, it can also go the other way, too. Okay, can I do that or not? Let's see. Let's just go here.
All right, king safety is a must. Hika, when did you start streaming exactly? Because I noticed, coincidentally, I think we both started streaming at the same time, and when you were streaming over there was so much boom happening because of you. And here, because of our community, there were so many people streaming at the same time. So it's like a boom that happened all over the world, like at the same time in chess.
Yeah, I mean, I think I really started getting serious about streaming. I would say, and it was like probably, what am I doing this game? I'm actually playing this quite badly. Okay, let's go here. Was in probably like October 2018 was when I really started getting serious. But my first streams were in July of 2017.
Oh, so you've been streaming for a long time, man.
Yeah, quite a while. Let's see.
Okay.
F5. Oh, right. This is also 3-0. I forgot. This is not 3-1. I thought there was an increment. There's no increment here. Okay.
Okay. What more question can I ask to distract him, chat? Oh, wait. I'm not muted. Wait. Kya puche bhai? Okay. That's a... Like... Up material exchange pieces, this is all I know. Nihal, man, do something. Okay, Nihal is taking time. I've never seen him do that before. Like, what do you see on the board when you see a position? Like, do you see these lines, these jets of lasers from every piece, where they move? What do you see? Because I don't see, I just see the pieces over there. Then I think, where can it go? Or it can go here.
Yeah, so normally it's like, because of the experience of playing a lot of chess, when you're looking at the board, it's like you kind of see certain moves. You see like four or five moves. Like, you see certain moves, and that's just like experience. So like, computers look at the whole board generally. I mean, that's how they do it. They look like brute force. They look this move, that move, every single move. Whereas like for me, like I'm just looking at like a couple of moves, like three or four moves, and that's it pretty much.
I have seen you draw arrows, man. You sometimes you see 70 moves deep.
Yeah, yeah. No, I mean, of course it's you can definitely do that, but normally it's just the experience more than anything. That's what it is. Just experience, so you kind of have some idea of what the moves are. Okay, h4 is a good move. Let's go here.
Oh man.
Yeah, it's probably just a draw with correct play, but we'll see.
This time.
Yeah, both of us are kind of low on time. Yeah, it's true. Okay.
Oh man. Okay. Why didn't you exchange?
On e3, because I'm down a pawn.
Ah. What, Hikaru has 30 seconds, what? Oh my god.
It's going to be a draw, don't worry. It's going to be a draw, don't worry. Oh, Nihal really should have won that game.
I have no idea what happened, but like it was epic. This game was epic. The bar just went. The bar was favoring Nihal plus three. I don't know what happened suddenly.
I can tell you what he did wrong. He did one thing specifically wrong.
That he streamed with me 2 days ago.
Oh, maybe that too. But actually, you know, it's funny. You know what he did wrong, and this is, another reason chess is so difficult, is his 25th move was he didn't put the queen on f3. He put the queen on d3. And after he put the queen on d3 and I was able to move my rook to this e5 square, I was able to then push my pawn like to g5 and g4, but also I was able to put both my rooks on this e-file as well.
Ah. So how had you gone on f3, so he couldn't have gone g5 and g4?
Yeah, see, like if he goes queen f3 and I go rook e5, then he takes the pawn on f4 because the rook's in the way of my bishop.
Ah.
That he should have won that game. I think if Nihal was in better shape, he should win that game probably like 80% of the time, I think.
Oh no, sorry Nihal, I broke you. And that's cool. We still get half a point. 0.5 is cool. So guys, we have 0.5 points against Hikaru's team, and that's good result. So let's update the score over here. Second.
Huh?
Hikaru, have you played this game called GeoGuessr?
Yeah, I have played GeoGuessr, yes. Yeah. Oh, sorry, I need to follow the player. Sorry, I took a look at kind of your good friend Anisha's game because I thought my chat was trolling, but he did in fact just get himself checkmated somehow.
Ah, that's sad. All right, are you following the next game?
Yes, I am following the next player. Yes. Oh, I should start the game. Okay. 1 second. Let me start the game. Okay. All right. Let's watch this game. Okay. B3, B6. Is this an opening that you're familiar with, Sameh, or what do you normally play?
I play 1 D4, 1 E4, 1 C4. B3 is, I think, Adiban's course or something. 1 B3.
Oh, did he do it? He did a course on that? Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. This is. Oh, you banned Nihal. Nihal should have won that game. I will say.
I'll just message Nihal once.
No, but I mean, he of course is very very talented. I mean, one of I think I don't know if you've heard this before, but I've said this to my chat. I mean, I think one of those four players I named earlier, and I don't know which one it will be, but I think one of those four players will be top 10 in the world at some point in chess.
Yeah, yeah, I'm sure. Like, there's so many talented people, like all the people you mentioned, Gukesh, Nihal, Prag, and Ronak. Like, I have all my bets on Nihal because this guy, I think he's just a genius who also plays chess. I've seen him do this GeoGuessr thing where he can just guess any country's flag in like 2 seconds. Just give him any flag and he'll guess it. And he has more superpowers like this. He's just a superhero and he's playing chess, I think.
Right, and of course that's also why I VIP'd him, because I mean, on top of being a genius, I mean, of course he also he made things more fair. So he's a VIP in my channel now.
Oh, what does a VIP get as perks?
Oh, it just means he's a very important person on the channel, and people will shower him with praise for being such a loyal member of the community.
Oh, that's awesome. That reminds me, Hikaru, there's something at stake here tonight, guys. If
What is the dare?
Yeah, the dare. Coming to the dare. So, all right. Yeah. So, Hikaru, you know, I've been trying to collab with you since I was born, right? So, if I win the sub battle, which we will, eventually, we have never lost, once we have lost. But if we win, which we will, again, I repeat, then Hikaru, you have to throw me a tweet. You have to give me a good shout out saying something on the lines of, you know, I love summer and all, whatever you feel like, you know, it's like anything.
That's kind of probably too nice. I mean, it has to be more than saying that I love you. That feels too nice. It's like, okay, I love you. It's great. Yeah, probably I'll think of something. Like, I'll say your greatest something. Yeah. But something better than that. Cause saying that I just, you know, that you're just really great. That's too mild. This is very serious business.
And if you win, which you won't, then I will tweet that I love GM Hikaru. Because I don't mind.
Okay, sure.
I love you.
Great. Right. Of course.
Let's go. H3.
Awesome. Yes, good move. The funny thing is, this is probably, I mean, at Grandmaster level, this is probably winning for Black. Maybe winning's too strong, but it's very, very good. But only because of the pawn formation on the queen side of the board.
Mm-hmm.
Because basically what can happen is Black can use the rook to attack the two white pawns that are kind of on what we call islands, because they're not connecting each other.
Oh.
Actually, no, you know what I want you to say, Sumei, is if I win, and of course I will, I want you to say that that I'm the greatest player ever. And Magnus Carlsen is just a wood pusher.
All right. Okay. It'll never come to that, but yeah, why not? In that universe, okay. Let's do it.
All right.
Like, you know, I've seen your reaction to this video of mine where I'd gone to this Gariahat flyover, and when I went there, there's a flyover in Kolkata, right, where they play chess. Everybody just said Hikaru, and then I found out that you were the one who inaugurated that place or something. Is it true?
That I did what? I inaugurated
it? You
were
the first person to play there or something like that.
Oh, I mean, probably, yeah, when we went there, I think we were probably the first people to play there, yeah. Yeah, it was me and Ding Liren. We were the two players who went there. It was a lot of fun. That's something that you never see, like, you would never see that in America. I don't think you see that anywhere else in the world, actually.
Yeah, I mean, it's like there's a lot of traffic everywhere, and then in the middle of the pandemic, in the middle of a traffic, people are just playing chess. You know, there were these two old people, they're just fighting on the board, they're abusing each other. Hey, man, that's... And, you know, they do all these cheap tricks like this. Look there. And then they take away your rook. You know, it's too much fun.
Yeah, no, I mean, that happens. I think I've seen that happen in many places, but not where... not like where it's more than a couple of people. There's small little parks like in America, or even in Europe, where you have people do this, but not where it's like, it felt like there were 100 people there when I went. And that's just like, it's amazing. And also the other thing that I know that's very different is you're lucky probably because have you been to any chess tournaments in India or not? Like, have you been to the Grand Chess Tour?
No, I've never. Long ago as a child, I'd gone, but never again.
Okay, because like when I was... let's see if my opponent, my guy can play this correctly, by the way. He should be winning.
Okay.
If he knows how to do the pawn formation push, he's winning.
Hey, Kyle, sorry for cutting you off. My chat has given me a better tweet that you can tweet if I win. You have to tweet, Sama is better chess YouTuber than Levy.
Oh, of course. Absolutely. Yeah, of course. Oh, no. What was Rook H1? Oh, no. We have another draw.
Oh, man.
Oh, no. Two draws. Wow.
But that's okay. We were losing, right?
Yeah, definitely losing. Yeah. That's a very good result. So it's kind of fair because Nihal should have won, but then my guy George should have won too. So are you ready for the next one?
I'll just be back in 30 seconds, right? I'll just give them some
motivational speech. Absolutely. Yeah, of course. Absolutely. So those guys who are wondering what he could have done, I'll tell you. You can basically do the pawn march. You march the pawns, and then you move the rook up. So the pawns are connected, but you can't push. So you move the rook up, then you push, then you support, then you...
क्या किया ये
क्या किया भाई
क्या किया ये हार रहे थे हम भगना है क्या सही पहले ही फटी पड़ी है भाई कर उससे क्या स्मॉल टॉक कर रहा हूँ डर लग रहा है भाई नर्वस हो रहा हूँ पहले ही मैं तुम सारा और नर्वस कर दो भाई गेम तो जीतो भाई तुम पे ही तो है भाई अपना सारा कंधा तुम जीतोगे तभी तो कॉन्फिडेंस आएगा बात करने में भाई हो
भाई नेक्स्ट
क्या नेक्स्ट भाई क्या कौन था ये ड्रॉ किया साला हार रहा था भाई 1v3 कौन खेलता है 1v3 कौन बोला 1v3 खेलने को
बड़ा क्या तू कौन
लूजिंग पोजीशन से ड्रॉ हुआ है भाई
अरे तो लूजिंग में आया क्यों तू 1v3 कौन बोला कौन खेल रहा है अगला कौन खेल रहा है भाई
अरे मैं नहीं खेला
कौन खेल रहा है अगला कौन है
भाई मैं विशाल
विशाल क्या खेलेगा
E4
जो E4 खेलेगा तू अगर हारा ना भाई विशाल तेरे क्या अश्लील फोटो मैं लीक कर दूंगा अभी इसके बाद ठीक है
हां भाई ठीक है
नो प्रेशर
Next thing I know, Anish is just busy getting like Ice Skater by Lupulescu. Anish wanted to collab with us, so he couldn't focus. Maybe true.
Hey, I'm
maybe
back.
Maybe true. Yes, I heard you were shouting at.
No. I was asking. Hey, man, that's amazing. I was motivating that you won from a losing position. You drew it, and that's a win. And he was sad. Like he was like, I wish I could have won. I was like, that's cool. It happens in chess. You win or you learn.
All right. Okay. Let's go to the next one.
All right. Let's go. Slow Dominator.
Okay. So two draws. So this is starting to look like a classical chess tournament so far. Okay. Actually, Sameh, what openings do you normally play in chess?
All the bad ones, man. All the bad ones. I play, like, I start off nicely with 1e4, 1d4, and then I manage to always lose some knight or hang in some there. So I started off with c4 initially, but then I got bored of it. This is something that happens with me. That I play an opening for so long that I memorize it and then it gets boring.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, of course. No, I mean, that's... But it's funny. So people, like, in chess, there are two types of people. The people who they learn that kind of opening at the start, and they just play it their whole life and try to get better off of it, and then people who basically try to experiment with everything. It's like two different approaches. But it's better if you're the second, if you experiment, for sure.
Yeah.
Because there's much more creativity. There's much more chess than one opening.
But then I get so attached to my rating. You know, like, I had reached 17-24 using only 1d4. And then my coach Sagar, he said, no, you have to now start playing E4. So the moment I switched to E4, E4 is such a complicated opening. It can lead to so many different things that now I've reached back to 1470. And, you know, but he says that that's the only way up, that you keep going down and you come up again.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, that's why it's I think mentally very, very difficult, because you go up and down. And I think, like, when you're younger, it's easier to not worry about that.
Yeah.
But when you're like, if you're an adult, I mean, it's very hard, because like that rating means a lot to you.
Yeah.
It means a lot.
It just keeps going up and down, man. It's like, what is it? Bitcoin.
Right. Yeah. Although Bitcoin went up for a long time.
Yeah, that's so in my rating, man. I went 1724 and now I'm like 1400s, can never go up. I just play very bad now. But I'm sure I'll get fine, which reminds me, Hikaru, towards the end of this, I want to challenge you for a 1 minute versus 25 seconds match. Is that cool?
That should be possible, yeah.
Okay, let's make it 20 seconds.
Sure, that's fine. Yeah, 20 seconds we can do.
Can we make it 13 seconds?
13, I don't think I can do. 20, I'll tell you why I think 20 is probably the upper end, because it's a matter of how many moves that I think you can survive for. And if you're 1470, I think you probably should be able to make, without getting checkmate, you should probably be able to make, I'm going to guess 40 moves. I think you can make 40 moves.
All right. So am I overrating? It's on. 1 minute versus 20 seconds.
Oh, but Nihal beat you with 10 seconds, 20 in a row?
Who said this? What is his username?
just someone called Yash B04. I don't
why
know
why would
you
do this, Yash? Are you why are you like this, man? Yash, are you not happy that our brother is happy here?
Okay, but in that case, I'll give you 10 seconds.
No, I don't need the sympathy. No, please. Now I will defeat you. I will defeat you with 20 seconds, man.
Okay, if you're sure,
yeah.
All right, what's happening? Your guy is a good position.
My guy is slowly dominating your guy.
The problem, though, is that it's both these games are very they're end games, so anything can kind of happen. It's not like a tactical game. This really does feel like classical chess so far.
Okay, knights exchange. Please exchange the knight, man. Make that pawn island. Hey, you can actually win the pawn. Knight takes, pawn takes, and then win the pawn, right? Oh, but then you get checkmated on f7.
I guess your guys aren't listening, and that was unfortunate. Because yeah, I was hoping that he would take on b4. I really was hoping for it.
A lot at stake here, guys. I'm reminding you, my members, if you're listening, which you are, there are no consequences. But play well, please. No consequences at all. Okay, what is this move? h3. I can see the bar go down.
Yes, this is not a great move.
Why though? I wonder.
That's also not a very good move. Okay.
Okay, queen
no
takes...
pressure, Dominator. No pressure.
Queen can take the pawn, right? On d4, it's like free.
Oh. Very few things in life are actually free, though.
Okay, please quote that. The top comment should be, very few things in life are actually free. Hikaru. Okay, knight c2. This is not good. Oh, now he can go. Yeah, queen e5, knight e3, queen takes f3, rook takes f3, rook takes e5, knight f5, knight d5, rook takes e5, bishop, b takes e5 then. Yes, that's correct. There's a fork over the knight. Boom!
Mm-hmm.
Why didn't you take the rook?
Very nice.
Ah, this was the idea.
Yeah, no, it's very well done. Still a chance. Time is still an issue. But I think at this level, I mean, your guy should win. He's up a rook and
and he's fully motivated.
Yeah. That too, yes.
Let's go. Rook d3 check. Come on. Oh, no. Don't go rook d3 check. Rook d2. Do something. Just do it fast.
No, but he likes to do things slow.
Okay. Exchange. Yeah, all is fine now.
Yeah, with the time situation especially, there's no way.
Should have made it a knight, man. Come on, man. Dominator. We should have dominated him slowly. All right. And there we go. Don't not stalemate.
It could happen. But no, actually, they're so high that it won't. Yeah.
Yes.
It was a good game.
That was That was a great game. Amazing. See, I tell you, these motivational talks really help.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's still very early, though. It's very early. We're only 3 games in. Many more games.
Up next is Vignesh to Savant versus yes. Heisenberg Blue. All right.
Yes.
I just follow them.
Mm-hmm.
Underscore blue.
Let's see. Okay. All your guys are playing b3 so far.
He also played b3?
Yes.
I'd advise him not to play b3. I wonder why they can't just listen to me, man. I'm such a strong chess player. Please listen to me. Do not play b3. Play 1e4, 1d4, man.
I mean, sometimes it's good. It's good to play it, but not always. Okay. All pretty right. Normal. Normal so far. Black is better, of course. Actually, Samay, can you figure out why black is better?
Because...
just like a general reason?
Because knight h5, g3, a5, right? That's what I said over there.
I mean, that is, but actually more I was saying... the thing is, conceptually, if you look at the white bishops, uh-huh. they're kind of blocked in, like, the light square bishop, there are pawns in the way. And the dark square bishop, he's just aiming at two pawns. So he's aiming at the black pawns in the center. So both the white bishops aren't really on open diagonals.
Oh, but once the position opens up with d4.
Right. And then it kind of changes a little bit. Yeah.
You know,
but it's just like, yeah, just a general concept.
I think Heisenberg's going to get forked here with d5.
Maybe.
Come on. d4. Let's go.
Okay.
Hey, Karu, man, why did you beat my bot 10 times, man? Can you please explain this to me? This is
because it's, I mean, apparently you're not that strong.
Many people keep asking me, guys, how did this collab happen? That's how it happened. Hey, Karu beat my bot 10 times. Then I tried to beat his bot once. I got checkmated in 2 moves. And then
I like that, by the way. That was nice. That was good.
Yeah. Come on, d4 now. D4 now.
Very complicated position.
Ah, d4 finally.
So, Sumay, did you start getting back into chess like right when the pandemic started hitting? I mean, or was it just like how did you come back to the game?
I mean, I had nothing to do, man. Honestly, my job was literally to gather crowds and tell them jokes. And
Right. No, I understand. But yeah. So kind of, yeah, when the lockdown happened. Yeah.
So I used to play chess long ago. I was my grandfather used to play with me. And, then I went to school where we did not have chess. So I couldn't play anymore. I used to go for some tournaments as a child. Like when I was Nihal's age. Not Nihal's age. Yeah. When Nihal started. Like when I was like in my third standard or something. But I sometimes think I wish I could have continued. Maybe I would be Nihal, but I didn't.
Mm-hmm.
So that's where it stopped. But then I started watching Agadmeter during my college days. And then the pandemic happened. And I was like, let me get into chess. Let me get into streaming. I started streaming. And the first thing that I thought of streaming was chess. Because, I love the game. And I thought if I do what I love, I'll find people who love what I do.
Oh, that's very inspiring. That's great. It's fantastic. Wow.
Please put this also, Samarana, quote.
Right, yeah.
Put this on my grave. This is the coolest stuff I ever said, man. Let's go with 95.
Yeah, no, it's... Yeah, 95 would be a great move here for White. It would be a great move. Great move. Let's see it.
Oh, no.
Great move by
why would you do this, Hikaru, man? You said great move. He played it.
See, I want to see my guy find one more great move.
Okay, there's a mate in 10 here. I'm sure he can't find it.
No, but the ratings aren't so high as I realized. The ratings are not super high. So it's kind of...
India is such a big country. It has great internet somewhere. But where I live right now, it's like you have just opened up this rant mode of mine. I live in this society, right? Where a lot of people live. And they simply don't understand the concept of digging to put broadband, man. They're like, no, do not dig in our society. It's bad. I want good internet for that. They require to dig. I say, they'll dig it. Then they'll fill it again. I will pay the price. You just have to watch. They're like, no, do not dig in our society. So I do not have good internet, man. I have very bad internet. I just hate them, man. These old people. That's why, never mind. It'll get too dark. But I was like, oh, COVID.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know. I understand.
Yeah.
It makes some sense. Yeah.
Guys, just refresh. It'll be fine. I watched Hikaru's chess videos on YouTube. Improved my rating from 900 to 1500. Shiraj Bharadwaj. Oh, that's awesome.
your guy's gonna win here, I think. Should win. Yeah, time is so bad. My guy's using too much time here. Yeah.
Finally,
it's not comfort. Possible. Yes. Good start.
Hey, thank you for the super chat, Nova King. Oh, take it. Yep. Take the rook. Beauty.
Mm-hmm.
Beauty.
Yeah, very nice.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. I'm so excited for the tweet.
It's only 2 points.
All right.
See what happens here.
Let's go. Third match is with Gangs of Wazapur. That's a great movie, actually. You should watch it sometime if you feel like watching a Bollywood movie. That's the go-to movie.
Okay. I haven't really watched Bollywood movies. It's just not something that really like makes it into like the American, I guess, culture. It's just not. I mean, I feel like I've probably heard of a couple, but not. It's just not something popular here, unfortunately.
Have you watched Have you heard of Three Idiots?
No, I haven't. No, Three Idiots. Okay.
I mean, it's a great movie. I'm not talking about me and my members, but it's like an amazing movie. You should watch it sometime. If you ever feel like watching a Bollywood movie, that's the go-to movie.
Mm-hmm. Three Idiots. Okay. Okay. Yeah, I'll check it out. Yeah, the problem is it's just like, unless you like actively search for it, it's just like American media will never cover any of that. So you just don't really hear about those movies. That's the problem.
Chad, any questions you have for Hikaru, go ahead. Please ask, because you might never get a chance again. Some ask Hikaru for other games like Dota 2, Among Us. What other games does he play? Would he play with you?
Oh,
Pranjal, that's a good question.
I haven't played Among Us in a long time. I played Among Us a little bit, but the problem for me is like if I play a game, I don't know if there's a way to categorize it, but I like games that like don't like end quickly. So like if there's a long storyline to a game, like something like
Age of Empires.
Which game?
Age of Empires.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, that's one of them. Yeah, I haven't actually played that one, but I am familiar with it. Yeah, games where it's a long storyline I like, but something like Among Us where it's like you play it like, I feel like when you play it five times, there's like not much left. You know what's going on. Like, it's just, it doesn't really have a story. There's no storyline. You just play it and it becomes repetitive. So it doesn't really, really excite me that much. But I mean, I have played it. I mean, something like League of Legends, I'll probably try. I played some Valorant. I played some Fall Guys.
Classical chess.
Yeah, classical chess. Yes, that's a,
it's a game,
yes,
with a very, yeah, long storyline, man.
Right. Yeah. That's true. Yes. Yeah, it has a very, very long storyline. Yeah, yeah, for sure.
In the middle of chess players walking away. You know, first of all, you never understand what happened. If you just look at the game like this, like, you can't watch a game like this, you know? You can't watch, mm-hmm, it. You can't watch a chess game like this, I feel. You need the bar and everything. Because you just see two people playing, they shake and they leave. You're like, what happened?
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing. It's like, that's why chess, I mean, unfortunately, I don't see it ever becoming as popular as a sport. Because, like, if you have the bar, you understand what's going on. But, like, without the bar, you can't, like, if I see, like, tennis or something, I see someone hit a terrible shot and the ball goes way out. Like, I know it's a bad shot. And chess, like, I know it's a bad move. But someone, if they don't have that experience, they can't just understand it easily. So I think having the bar it's a great, 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 invention's the wrong, but it's a great thing to add to the game. The only thing I would say, though, is I don't like it when people start using it in their commentary all the time, because then it's like you're not thinking for yourself. And that actually hurts your chess ability,
oh,
too.
Damn. Okay, guys, shots have been fired at me. that's all I do, man. I just see the bar. Sometimes the bar...
Well, you know, actually, but where you're at, I don't think it's a big deal.
Yeah.
But the thing, I'll give you an example. It's like, let's just say someone's like 2,200, like master level. If you get too used to using the bar, then when you actually have to play the game without the bar there, like, your brain stops functioning, basically. You can't do it. You're too used to seeing
it. You get dependent on it. Yeah, it's like drugs.
Yeah. It's like what?
It's like shrugs, you know, like doing this. You do a lot of this and then you get dependent on
this. Oh, okay, okay.
It's like shrugs.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
You know, and sometimes, you know, even if you put a position, I've seen some positions are so beautiful that even the bar doesn't, mm-hmm, understand it. Like, once I had put a position between you and Vidit, there was a game where he gave you a check with his king and the bar just went crazy. The bar was like, what is this?
Ah, yes, you know? Yes.
So chess is a beautiful like that, but bar can't understand all the moves, I think, sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, right. You did say drugs, right?
I said shrugs. I said shrugs. Why would you say drugs, okay, man? What's up? We don't, okay, do that stuff, okay, here, man, on YouTube.
Right. True. Yeah. All right. Wow, somehow this game has turned in your favor again. Wow.
That is the fear. That is the love of the Supreme Leader, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I shower them with love on Discord every night.
Yeah, but it's... The good thing for me is that your guy's moving too slowly. Come on, Moscatel. Good. Very good.
Come on, Moscatel. I'll give you diamond membership, man. Knight F3 check.
You gotta
move. Bishop take. Now knight F3 check.
It doesn't really do a whole lot, but... Come on, Moscatel. Move. Keep going.
Oh, he missed it. Oh, what?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
How do you not, like, get so mad at watching
these moves? Yes! Come on. Let's go. Yes.
What? I'll just be back in 30 seconds, you know? I'll just...
Sure, absolutely, yeah, absolutely. Take your time. Just take your time.
दुनिया देख रही है भाई 30,000 लोग यहाँ देख रहे हैं वहां पता नहीं कितने लोग रहे थे मैं तारीफ कर रहा हूँ यहाँ पे बेंचो रुक ब्लंडर हो रहा है नाइट F3 खेलने के बाद नाइट दे रहे हो भाई नाइट क्यों दिया भाई मैं ये बोतल फोड़ूंगा तेरे मुंह पे भाई बैन करो इसको बैन करो बी स्टैट्स
कर दिया बैन कर दिया
बी स्टैट्स को बैन करो इसको नहीं ये बंदा सही है बी स्टैट्स को बैन करो
ठीक है भाई
बी स्टैट कहां से लेके आया भाई अगला कौन है
मैं हूं
कौन है तू
रैंडमाइजी
अरे रेटिंग बता नाम से क्या करूं मैं
18 13 80 के आसपास
भाई अगर आज तू आगा भाई
तेरी रेटिंग में चेजॉन को बोल के चार कर दूंगा भाई, चार ही है फिर तेरी रेटिंग जिंदगी भर चार, तू कितना भी खेल तेरी रेटिंग बढ़ेगी नहीं उधर से।
अरे जीतेंगे ना
भाई। रैडम जी फ्लैग करना एक कला है भाई, लास्ट के 5 सेकंड में करें फ्लैग, 10 सेकंड में करें फ्लैग, ऐसे नहीं कि आधा घंटा बचा है और फ्लैगिंग चालू है भाई।
अरे फ्लैगिंग तो सीखा है निहाल वाली स्ट्रीम से।
हाँ भाई, भाई पिछला बंदा कौन था भाई?
पिछला बंदा भाई बैन हो गया।
बैन हो गया ना भाई, देख रहे हो भाई खौफ? ठीक है भाई रैंडम जी, खौफ देख रहे हो तुम?
देखा देखा,
नो प्रेशर भाई। ऑलराइट, हे आई एम बैक। Can't hear you.
Lecture. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So he was very sad and he was like, you know, I lost. And I was like, don't worry, you have to stay hydrated, drink some water, you'll be fine. You know.
Mm-hmm. He'll live. He'll live.
He'll
yeah.
live. He'll live. He'll be fine.
Yeah. All right. Let's see. Next game is Twitch Ubisu, I guess, is your player. Okay. Let's go. All right. Randomize. Okay. So far it's going well for you, I think. Normally I start out slowly. So I think I think you should be very worried. This is what, the Nidorf?
This is just 1380 player playing some developing moves. There's no
Nidorf. But you know what's funny is I think I played an Indian player in the World Youth, and I don't know if they played bishop to d3 or queen d3, but they played something like this in against me in like in a World Youth Chess Championship in like 2000 and 2099. Okay. Something's very similar to this.
2099.
Sorry, I said 2000 or 1999. Sorry. Yes, but still, either way, yeah, that was a very long time ago, of course.
Do you think a Hikaru chess will ever be solved?
I would say doubtful is what I would say. Doubtful. Yeah, I mean, maybe if computers get to some kind of, there's some computing advance, it's possible, but I don't really see it happening. At least in terms of it being like a hard solve where, you know, when you play e4, it's a draw in like 50 moves. I just don't see it.
You know, I was watching this amazing movie called AlphaGo. Have you watched this documentary?
Yes, I have actually, yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's so cool. And just seeing that Lee Sedong, how he defeats that computer, and then he says, you know, defeating this computer once makes me believe there's still hope for humanity. And that's such a powerful right. line. And you know, it's like, I just hope that it never gets solved, man. I hope that we are still always, there's always some but beauty. I
mean, but isn't that kind of the point though? Like Go is not actually, it's not hard solved. Like the computers beat the humans, but it's not like it knows from move one.
But Go is also more complicated than chess, no? But
True. Yeah, it's much more complicated. But yeah, I mean, that was a great, I watched it and that was a great, great, great documentary.
It's like when for example, I saw Vishy versus Ian, there was a move he made. Vishy makes a move and the bar doesn't understand. The computer doesn't understand it. Then it understands. And that these moments are when I'm like, oh, there's still hope for humanity, you know? That humans can still play some amazing chess.
That's vanishing quickly, though.
Uh-huh. Thank you, Hikaru, for breaking all my hopes.
Well, but because I think the thing that's actually even more crazy, like if I think about just AlphaGo, is that like that after that documentary, there was like a better version of the computer that came out, and that better version of AlphaGo beat the version that beat Lee Sedol by like it beat that version 100-0 or something.
Wow!
So like it just improved beyond like it's just crazy.
Have you ever got the chance to play against AlphaZero?
No, I haven't had that opportunity. I don't think anyone has actually, except maybe Kramnik. But it's like, but what's the thing is like, it's, I don't even know how to put it. You can't learn anything. That's the problem. Like you lose every game and there's nothing you can learn.
Hey, that seems so like all my chess streams, man.
Oh, okay. Yeah. 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 But although the difference is though, like if you play me and you lose a game, I can actually tell you what I did. Like I have an actual reasoning behind it. And the computer can't tell you. So it's like you lose the computer can't even explain anything. At least if you lose to me, I can tell you why I played that move and like what my idea was. Whereas a computer, it just gives you some numerical thing and that's it. So you never can actually learn anything.
Yeah, and I was seeing some of the games, like Levy had done this video where he was analyzing the games. And it was amazing how AlphaZero plays, just playing B3, B4, B5, and then just going, strangulating the opponent, just suffocating them and not following any theory. This is epic.
Right, but the problem is then, like, because top players are trying to improve their game, we know the computers play the best chess, but then the problem with that is that when we, by the way, your guy's losing in the meantime.
Oh, no.
But when like when top players try to use, we try to think like computers and do these things, it becomes like you don't really understand what you're doing anymore, because it's like, okay, it plays B3 and then B4. And so like, if I try to apply that in my thought process, like, well, in this position, should I push the pawn 2 squares or 1 square? But like, there's no difference to me. Like, so then you start to wonder, like, what exactly does the computer even see? Like, what is chess at all?
Yeah, what is chess at all? Exactly. You know, because the way that AlphaZero comes, learns chess is by playing against itself. And that's what was the most fascinating part of that documentary. What they made, they showed a scene where they made this computer play that simple game where there's a ball that you hit and it breaks a block, it comes back to you, you hit it again. And as the computer kept playing it again and again, it kept getting better and better and better and kept realizing the best way to play it. And that's what it did with chess. It kept playing with itself and again, and then it found out the best way to play chess. So literally, like, what is chess? It makes you question that. What is theory? What do we, you know?
Right, exactly. It just doesn't make any sense at all. No, it's very true. This game's really, really intense.
Oh man, Rook G4, save it, please. Oh no.
Yes. Good move. Very good move. Mm-hmm. Yes. Very good. Do you need another break?
I just need 10 seconds, man.
Why? What did you. I'm not muted. Kya kiya bhai?
Arey, sorry, bhai. Sorry.
Kya haga ye? हम यहाँ अल्फा जीरो बात कर रहे हैं भाई, तुम्हें यहाँ पे जीरो पे ले गए पूरा मैच, तुम्हें अल्फा हो क्या भाई, जीरो पे चले जाओगे सीधे।
सॉरी मैं
भाई, बी स्टैट्स कहाँ भाई किशोर?
डेफन हो रख,
बैन कर उसको, डेफन क्यों किया है भाई? अगला कौन है भाई?
समेत लीडर भाई, मैं
तनिष। तूने अभी तक बहुत अच्छा अच्छा गेम खेला है भाई,
थैंक यू सो मच।
थैंक यू नहीं है, अभी भी खेलना है भाई, तेरी उल्टा हारने की प्रोबेबिलिटी ज्यादा है क्योंकि तू इतना जीता है। तो अभी यार भाई देख भाई, तने स्कोर क्या चल रहा है यार, मैं तेरे को बताता हूँ स्कोर क्या चल रहा है।
इक्वल हो गया ना, इक्वल
भाई, इक्वल हो गया भाई, प्लीज। नहीं इक्वल नहीं हुआ एक्चुअली, 3-2 है, 3-2 है, 3-2 है भाई।
नहीं नहीं, मैं 4-2 लेके जाऊंगा,
लेके जाएगा ना?
हां,
अगर नहीं लेके गया तो तेरी अश्लील फोटो में लीक कर दूं फिर।
अरे यार
तूने भेजी है ना फोटो?
हाँ
दोस्तों, माँ कसम चैट, मैंने इन सबसे फोटो मंगवाई है, सबसे मंगवाई है मैंने फोटो, ठीक है? तो मैं इनकी लीक कर दूंगा भाई,
उसके उसके टाइम नहीं आएगा,
नहीं आएगा ना उसके, वहां तक आएगा नहीं ना बात, चलेगा। ऑल द बेस्ट भाई तनिष भाई, प्लीज भाई, तनिष भाई भीख मांग रहा हूँ तुझसे भाई, जिता दे भाई।
अरे नहीं भाई,
प्लीज भाई, प्लीज मैं करता हूं, प्लीज भाई, प्लीज प्लीज, तुझे रोज खाना खिलाऊंगा यार, अपने हाथों से खिलाऊंगा यार, प्लीज थकना मत।
यस,
ऑल द बेस्ट। Hey, I'm back.
Yep. All right. So I hope that went well. It's you might need to improve though, because that's 2 times you've done this now in a row, and it definitely has gone the wrong way.
No. This time I actually showered this person with real love, and I said, you know, it's okay, and you can do it. And this guy has the next guy has always won the battles. Every time he has stepped here, he has won. So he's like the Floyd Mayweather of my team.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, let's see. Okay. Here we go. The game start or not? Okay.
Did you by any chance follow the match, the Hug It Out match today between Floyd and
I didn't. I mean, I read some stuff. I wasn't going to pay $49.99 for it because I knew it would be unsatisfying.
Unsatisfying, so I would have been an upgrade.
Okay. I never paid for any of the matches, but I knew when I was following the other one with McGregor, and it was also kind of not super exciting. I knew this one would be even less exciting. So that's what I would say. Yeah, I knew it was going to be something like that, but also it's very smart. But also kind of why the whole thing is a joke is that I knew like, why would Mayweather want to knock out Paul? I mean, he probably could have, but why would he want to?
Why not?
Because he's retired.
But still, he can just throw in a big punch and just get all that pride, right? Like, look, this guy was trying to be cool and now I beat him.
Right, but I mean, at the end of the day, you would rather have a shot at $100 million again than like not having a shot, especially since he's retired.
What would you do? Would you beat me? Like, if you and I were in a boxing match and you were like a pro, you know, wouldn't you be like, let me just punch this guy down and get all the clout and like, you know? because right now it's, I think it was, they hugged so much in that match, it did more damage to Floyd than Logan, I feel.
But I mean, he just wants to get paid.
That's true. His second name is Money.
Yeah, I mean, that's just American capitalism. I mean, that's all it is. Like, everybody just wants to get paid. But yeah, I mean, I think actually at some, but the problem also, I think, is that he probably wasn't, he wasn't ever tested. So he never was in any danger. That's the thing. Like, if he was in danger, I think Mayweather, like the instinctive, like just being a boxer, like those natural instincts could come out. But because he was never in danger, like there was never like a one hit that just like there was never a punch that really landed. Like he never had, it never kicked in. But I think if he had been in like in danger, he'd gotten like knocked around a little bit. Then I think at some point that those instincts would have kicked in. Yeah. But he was never in that situation, so it was easy to kind of not have to like think like that.
Because like I could see Logan had his guard down most of the time, his hands were down, he was not defending himself. Mm-hmm. So you know.
Yeah, well, I mean, because like when I think about it in chess, it's kind of the same way. Like if I think about playing like someone who's like, let's just say they're 2000 level. If like I'm just winning the whole game or it's like just very calm kind of, I never have to get like super competitive or really into it. But if I end up in a bad position, at some point those natural instincts start to kick in. So that's kind of the thing. It's like it's one of those situations where I think because there was he was never in danger, Mayweather never really, he didn't have to really think like that.
Oh, something happened here. Hey, Karu, can you
yeah, something good happened. Yeah. Yeah, something good happened here. But yeah, it's I knew it was not going to be good. I knew it would not be good.
All right. What's the movie? Queen H3, I would play here.
Yeah, that's a move. It's a good move. Maybe a great move.
No. I don't trust you. I don't trust
you. Queen G6, though, I think is a very, very bad move. Because what it does is it creates a threat that's too obvious or should be too obvious.
What is the threat?
Yeah. Yeah, see, the problem with this move is that it forces White to play a move to stop the checkmate, and now you never have a threat. That's the problem.
How about Knight F5 now?
Also a move. Maybe a great move again. I think it's a great move. Yes, it's a great move. Yes.
Man. No, man. Why do I even ask you?
It's not over though. It's still, anything could happen here, to be fair. It's still not clear. There's still enough pieces on the board that even though it's completely winning for one side, it could go the other way too.
Can you go can you sack at any point on knight takes g3, pawn takes, like right now the knight is guarding it, but
yeah,
at some point.
No, I mean that's also a possibility. I mean, it could be very dangerous in a move or two, possibly. Could be very dangerous.
Or maybe knight h4 is also coming sometime. Knight h4
that's
is the
also
idea,
possible.
Knight f3.
Yeah. It really depends on what happens in the next like two or three moves, but this could go either way. I think your guy could still win this position for sure.
Also, the time is the big factor.
Yeah, time actually matters more than anything in these sub battle games.
Time can heal or ruin anything.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Wait,
I like this move actually, even though it's not the best move. I like this move.
How about rook c8, get tempo on queen, and then go knight takes h4.
That's a possible move. You can also trade the rooks. Okay, it's actually a good move. My guy needs to move faster. Come on, Emil. Faster. Come on, Emil.
All right.
Wow, that's a great move. Very, very good move.
This is a bad
move. Come on, Emil. Keep going, Emil. Keep going.
Take your time, Emil. There you go. How about rook e8 right now? Rook e8. And
that's yeah, rook d1 could be a move.
Rook d1. Oh, no. You said rook d1.
Oh man. The problem is both players are low on time.
Anything can happen here. Why would you King? Take the rook. It's free, man. The rook was free. The rook is still free.
Yeah, there's still moves. Oh, yeah, it's good. Take. Move the king. Come on, move the king. Move. Go a mill. Just fast.
Do not hang your queen.
Go, Emil. Just move.
Exchange. No. What? Play fast.
Move.
Do not exchange.
He went. He has more time.
But he is now thinking. Why is he thinking?
Hilarious.
Oh, we won, right?
Yeah, yeah, you got one. 0.3. Oh. That was crazy.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Only I had my heart rate monitor over here.
Yeah, that really went back and forth. Time matters a lot at the end of these games. It really does.
That's awesome. That's awesome.
It's up one. You're up 1 point. Still a long way to go.
4-3. All right. Mm-hmm. We up next, we have Atulia 124. And as we keep going to the lower rated players,
anything becomes much more predictable.
Yeah, and it becomes much more fun.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, no, this is okay, so far, normal.
All right.
Let's see what's happening. Okay, pretty normal. Very classic.
I love how all these players are playing the correct openings, developing all the pieces. And then suddenly I don't know what happens to them in the endgame.
Yeah. No, but the thing is also, the endgame probably doesn't really matter so much. Other than really basic endgames, endgames don't matter probably until you're already, I would say 1800, maybe 1800 or thereabouts. Balanced endgames just don't happen until maybe that level or around there. Someone's already winning by that point most of the time.
Mm-hmm. D5 is not a good move, right? It blocks our bishop.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it blocks the diagonal. Yes.
Okay, just get exchanged, I guess. It's a good or no?
Mm-hmm.
I've understood now the difference between good knight, bad bishop, and
That's very good that you understood that the pawn on D5, that push was not good, because it's not the most obvious thing to think about, how it closes diagonal for the bishop on A2. So that's actually very good.
Are you nervous about the match now? 1 minute versus 20 seconds.
Not really. Because I think anything can happen here. But I will say that right now this is not looking good, mainly because of the time. The time is a big problem for my guy. It's 30 seconds more. That's a big problem.
I just hope we win this. I get the lead. I'm comfortable.
Sub battles usually don't work out that way. Usually they're close until the end. But maybe this time it won't be. We'll see.
Okay, knight e2. Knight d4.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
There you go. Looking very...
That was not such a good decision. Yeah.
Hey, knight c6 is there somewhere, right?
It was one of those moves, but not necessarily. Very, very, very unclear. There are moves for both sides. Let's see. Okay, rook f5. That's actually a good move. Rook e8's a very good move, too.
Why is he not going knight c6?
Probably because he sees a trick.
Now he goes, okay.
Okay. Let's see. Okay. Okay. Pretty normal still.
I think sometimes when you're winning in chess, you're more nervous.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. I think when you know you're winning, it's not just a normal position, but when you know that you have a really, really good position, it's very easy to become confused. Also, I think your guy's going to win because the time situation is already so bad. So it's hard to see your guy not winning this. He would have to make some kind of special blunder like that. But I'm not sure my guy will find the move.
What is the move?
There's a certain move. There's some forks. Oh, he saw it. Wow.
Okay, how about
Although queen? It's still not obvious. Yeah. It's still not obvious because there's still more moves to the sequence.
But my guy has time. There he goes. Yeah, he finds the
move. It's a good move. Let's see if my guy can find the move here.
There's still no move here.
Yeah, there's a move that that wins the rook.
Okay, let's see. I see what you're saying. F6, come on.
Yes. Found it. Wow. But the problem is the time is so bad here. I mean, unless my guy magically is a specialist in blitz, he's gonna lose on time. Because he's down 1 minute here. Okay, you got to go, Tiger. You got to go. Okay, good.
Oh.
Okay, keep going. Keep going.
Why are you desperate to exchange queen, man? Okay. Is this good for white?
No, it's very bad for white.
But only 24 seconds. Oh, there he goes. So proud. I'm so proud.
Yeah, that was pretty bad.
How come you have no emotions, Hikaru? You have zero emotions. I'm going on a roller coaster of emotions here by looking at the bar.
Well, because I know that the play will not be so high. I think like if I know the players are a little bit higher, I would be much more animated. But because the players,
they're not higher. That's the point.
Yeah, they're not higher, so I've gotten used to it. I have low expectations.
Please get high and play the matches. And and rating, of course, guys. Oh, you give up. Oh, but you guys have only 3 seconds.
Yeah, I mean, he almost misplayed that there. I mean, he almost misplayed that.
Boom.
That was pretty insane.
There you go, guys. Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, now you're looking good. With what, four to go, you're up two. So let's see. Okay. All right. So my guy really needs to play this well here. If he doesn't play this well, then this could be it almost.
Any motivational talks that you can give your guy? Go ahead. I'm telling you,
my guys are doing well. It's just time. I mean, I don't even know how to say that across different levels, even, because it's just all about time. It's just about time. That's all that really matters.
Yeah,
it's hard because when you tell someone to just make a move quickly, it's like then they just blunder. So it's like there's some kind of weird, there's some weird balance, and I don't know how to explain it, but there's some kind of balance.
Yeah, there's a saying in India that it goes "Lato ke bhoot baaton se nahi mante," which means that the ghost that needs to be kicked away with your leg, you can't ask him to go away with your words.
Ah, okay, yeah, I know. I mean, it's
so you need to really, you know, grind on your members, and that's, oh, look at that blunder.
Oh, what was that? What was F3?
That was
a very weird move.
That was a lack of fear. I think you have not made them scared enough to play this sub battle. That's all it is. Oh, like queen h4 check. Go ahead. Mate in two, man.
Yeah, that's just weird. What was that? That felt like a throw.
I'm telling you, Hikaru, it works every time. You have to give them some, you know, prep talk.
Normally my subs do quite well, actually. That actually was the worst game by a big margin. Worst game. Not even close. Yikes.
All right.
Okay.
5-3, right? 5-3. Is it 5-3 or 6-3?
Yeah. No, I think it's 6. I think it's 6-3, isn't it? That's 3 in a row, if I'm not mistaken. I think.
All right. Chat, only you can tell us. Okay, up next is Master Manish, 21.
Yeah. Actually, no, I think it's 5-3. It's 5-3, I think. Yeah, I think it's 5-3, actually. So it's not.
Is it 5-3?
Yeah. It is 6. I don't know. My chat say, half my chat says 5-3, the other half says 6-3. I'm not sure.
My chat's saying 8-3, man. Come on, chat.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, they say it's 6-3. All right.
6-3, right. Okay. Yeah. Okay, pretty normal.
There you go. Guys, everybody watching, please like the stream and please somebody put Hikaru's channel link in the chat. I'll pin it. Go pay a visit. He does amazing, amazing content. I mean, of course, he's one of the best grandmasters. Who else can make such great content? So please go check it out.
Okay, I'm trying to get... Okay, I think my guy has a good position here. He's doing well.
But he's also 936.
Yes, of course. But he's doing well, I think.
There is... Like, these games are like Alpha Zero, man. You can never predict. Anything can happen.
Yeah. No, I mean, I know he's doing well, but I base that only on the structure of the pawns, nothing else. That's all that I base it on. Nothing else but the structure of the pawns.
I think what's going to happen is knight b5 and knight c7.
That's an interesting idea. Wow, queen e3 is a pretty good move. Pretty good move here. Let's see. Okay.
Thank you, Joy. Hikaru, do you play poker?
I used to play quite seriously, yeah. Why?
Chad was asking, just, you know, some super chats. I was just going through them.
Yeah, I mean, I used to play, but I think the problem is, like, in order to be very good at chess, you... Ooh.
Okay, oh, Chad yes. is now saying it's 5-3 again. Okay, Chad, it's 5-3.
Okay, here we go. But yeah, I mean, I used to play, but the problem is, like, in poker, it requires, like, the same kind of analytical skills for chess. But there's that factor of luck that, like, especially if you get to, like, the upper levels of chess, don't really, it's not something you can apply in the same way. So,
but is it really luck? Well, I feel that poker is like 90% skill, maybe 10% luck, very little luck.
I mean, but the problem with that is that I think it requires you playing for like a whole lifetime for that to be true, probably.
For you to understand range.
Well, because I mean, for example, if I play poker, let's just say I play poker for the next week, I could just play odds. I could play it correct and lose like all the time. Like I could just play very well and just lose. So over those 2 weeks, it's very bad. But you know, you can have these long periods where you do badly, and so you don't really know like how like when that what the period of time is kind of. Anyway, okay, my guy's gonna win here. I think he should.
C5. Just don't let that. Oh no.
Yes. Very good.
This was so embarrassing.
Good. That was these last two games were not the best games ever. Definitely not.
It's a very polite way of saying, what the hell did you guys do?
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Let me see. Okay. Wait. Whoops. Just make sure. Okay, and then so my guy won here as well. Okay. Okay. So it's what? 5 it's 5-4 now, I believe.
Oh my god, it's so close.
Yeah, let me pull up the next one. Yeah, so it's 1 point lead with 2 games left. Ugh. So, okay.
And so also our game will also be counted, Hikaru, 20 seconds or 1 minute.
Oh, okay. I mean, if you want to, that only makes it more difficult for you. Unless your guys just run it out and they just win every game here.
I accept it. I accept this trash talking.
Yeah, I mean, maybe.
Okay, bishop d7. Come on, let's go. Let's castle queen. No, we can't castle with the queen. Let's castle queen side. I was trying to say. e5. Open up your bishop. Let's go.
Yeah, I think. No, it's 6-4.
It's 6-4? It's six,
looking at the sheet. Yeah, oh. it's 6-4 right now. Yeah, it is. It's 6-4.
Oh, that's awesome. So there's no pressure on my guy. That's cool.
Yeah, I mean, unless your guys lose the last two games, and then you'll definitely lose. So they have to get 1 point, I think. Or no, yeah, they need to get 1 point to guarantee it.
And seems like it, that this is going to be the game. You know, the thing with our my lower boards is that they all know basic opening theory and all of that, thanks to, you know, Sagar Shah, who teaches every day on Chessbase. So what he does is he teaches in such a cute way, you know, like... Imagine, he tries to personalize these pieces, like, talk to the pawn, look at the pawn, he wants to come out, it's like a kid, and that way, it's very easy to understand. So, I'm sure these guys know how to play their opening very well, and it gives them a good position. And then, what they know is that if you're in a better position, just exchange pieces. So, these
right,
two
right,
things
exactly, yeah.
Is what I think will help us on the lower boards.
It should. Although I have to ask, I'm not sure that's what my guy watches. I mean, I see the Indian flag, but I also see I see Levy's face as well
on there.
On
no.
First flare.
Oh,
yes.
So it's actually Levy versus Sagar Shah here, guys.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Yeah.
Come on, man. Rohit, no, are you not patriotic, man? Let us win here, please.
Yeah, it's very, very tricky. I don't know what to make of this position.
It's drawish. It's no more drawish.
It's draw. No, but I mean, I think this position's not drawish. Somebody will win this game. I just don't know who's going to win.
chess is
but one of these two guys will win. Yeah. Okay. Now I think now your guy will win.
Probably. Rook takes king f7 and then we win that pawn.
Yeah.
Boom.
Yeah. I mean, your guy should win this just because it's an end game and neither of these guys can know this end game.
That pawn is also hanging right on h4.
Well, now there's a pawn hanging on h7 too.
But he's 600 also.
Right. Yeah. I mean, the side that has the extra pawn here should win the game.
I hope it's not draw by repetition here, man.
No, I don't think this will be a draw.
Do you know, I had no idea about draw by 50 move rule until like I was like 1500.
Oh, really? Wow. Okay, don't. Yep, and that's it.
That's an end passer. There you go.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Wrong side of the board. Yeah.
So, yeah, Hikaru.
How
do you feel? I feel amazing.
I think your guys have played pretty well, actually. I mean, normally there's more drama, but I feel like your subs have just played better, objectively. I mean, like, normally there's some crazy blunders, but I feel like the blunders in this have been pretty minimal, if I look at it. Like, you haven't seen, like, the crazy swing. Like, the side that's normally better should win the game, and they have. So, also, yeah, as we see, Sagira, of course, clearly slightly better. Slightly better.
We have a super chat from Sire Moth Yagar. Sire Moth Hikaru is one of the most amazing rap duos of India. They are so good at what they do, and they also follow chess. They've just got into chess, so they are saying, Hikaru, oh my god, this stream is fire.
This is
all right, let's go. 7-4. I know, Chad. We have already won the battle, but we have to also win the war at the end of this against Hikaru.
True. Although I think this is the war and that's a battle.
No. For me, that is after what you said to me, that 20 seconds, that option and all that, I am so hurt, Hikaru. I'm going to go all out on you.
This is the war, because I'm pretty sure the battle is going to go the other way.
All right. I like this. God, if you let me win today, I will every day pray. I'll pray every day. I'll go to the temple. I'll donate money. Just if you are there, man. Please, bro, help me out here. Thank you. All right, I've done my prayers. Okay, come on. What's happening? Chat, I will seriously pray. I will seriously pray every day if I win. Queen g3?
You're going to win again. This game, you're also going to win too, I think.
I don't care about this game anymore. It's about the next game.
Okay, yeah. We'll see. We'll see. Let's see. Okay. Yeah, your guys have played pretty well. I mean, their openings have been very good throughout. So it's you have some very strong subs.
Yeah. Oh, now f5, f3.
Mm-hmm. F3 is a move. It's a good move. It's not the best move, though.
Is it not?
Yeah, it's a good move. But the problem with f3 is that, yeah, h3 is the right move. So f3 hung the bishop on d3. It blocked the queen from guarding. h3 is the best move.
Oh, should have taken with the queen, maybe.
No. That would have hung the bishop on d3.
Oh, man. All right, let's go. Let's put a mate on h7. Yes, that's right. Wait, mm-hmm. What?
No, there's a pawn in the way of the bishop.
Okay, we might still win this. Just exchange the rooks. Come on, man. That's right.
Yeah, no, this is very, very good. By the way, as people are saying, the 600 is kind of playing better than you do.
It's just cyberbullying, guys. Please don't do this in the name of chess, man. I'll prove you all you guys wrong in the next match with Hikaru. I'll show you my true strength. all right, just exchange everything. They're both playing pretty well, actually, from since a long time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, this is what I was saying. Normally, they're more like more crazy blunders. There's the one game with that the end game, the queen, the one with 0.3. But other than that game, there haven't been many games with big swings, like queens hanging and so forth.
The super chat. Hikaru also shares interest in finance, investment, stock, Wall Street. Oh, that's interesting.
Yeah. I mean, I've done that for many years now. It's just something mm-hmm. that I've looked at. Although I think the thing is nowadays everyone's looking at it, so it's not hip anymore. It's not that cool.
Were you into Dogecoin by any chance?
No, I wasn't. Because the problem is since I kind of started more like I've always looked at like fundamentals. Like I can't just look at something if I can't assign a value to it. Like it's hard for me to speculate on something. Like I'll give you an example. One of the things that I spent a lot of time on in the past was looking at like biotechnology stocks. So it's very, very speculative. But the thing is, it's based on an event happening. So it's like, you know, if a company comes out with a drug that sort of cures a certain cancer, for example, then the stock maybe will go up or down a lot. But when I see something where I don't see a reason or a catalyst, something that will make it go up or down, I can't really get that into it.
Got it. Hey, we won.
Meanwhile, your guy won by timeout.
Oh, yeah. Man, we won by timeout.
Actually, with a minute on the clock to spare, it was just like game over.
Oh, so officially, guys, we have won the sub battle. Chat, somewhere open in the chat, but now is what I was waiting for. All right, Hikaru, whenever you're ready.
Yes,
I have
what
made
color
my
do
place.
You want?
Okay, I want white.
You want white? Okay, yes. let me start the game. Give me 1 second. Okay, all right, and I think I should be able to get the time set to 20 seconds. Just make your first move, and I'll try to adjust my time down to 20.
All right. I can do that too. I'm equipped. Okay, 1 sec. Chat. Are you ready, chat? Hey, wait. There's no chat. This chat is disabled. 1 sec, no? I'll just start the match. Sure. I'll just do a rematch. Can you make your time 20?
Sure. Yeah, no. I have one of my other mods doing it. Yeah.
All right. I've requested a rematch.
Okay. I don't actually see it, but yeah.
Okay.
One of my other mods can do it. That's fine. That's fine.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
3381, man. What is this rating?
Mm-hmm.
It says, "Boss, Hikaru, a good sport." Okay.
There we go. There we go. Okay, so I'll have one of my other mods will do. Just make your first move, and it should be adjusted. Okay. Can you adjust it? Let me see. It's gonna adjust it.
It says chat is disabled. No, so I think he can't write.
Yeah. I know the chat is disabled. That's why I have someone else do it.
We can just wait. We can just wait for 30 seconds.
Okay. Sure. Okay. That's fine too. Okay.
Okay, you're only 20 seconds, not 21, not 22, 20.
Yeah, no, I know. I'll let it get a little bit under 20 anyway, because I made one move, so right. It's only fair. Yeah.
Chad, what do you think?
Okay. I'm thinking too what I'm going to play here, because you're playing d4 and c4, very aggressive. Okay, let's see.
Okay. Hold on, go for it.
There we go. Pretty good so far. Ooh.
Why is my heart beating so fast? What to do? Oh, no.
Yeah.
got one rematch, please, man. One rematch.
Sure, sure, sure. Okay, sure.
You know what? I'll just,
yeah, okay.
Just connect my.
Yeah, I'll let my timer down again. Yeah, I'll let my timer down.
Connect my other mouse.
That was just the mouse. Your mouse just got stuck.
Yeah, my mouse is. This is a different mouse that I have. That's not an excuse, by the way. You won fair and square.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. True.
Okay, this is the mouse.
No worries. You still have 20 seconds. No worries. Plenty of time. Plenty of time to get your mouse fixed.
All right. It's set.
Okay.
This is it.
All right. 10 seconds.
Okay.
Let's see.
Are you going to go with 10 seconds?
No. Oh, I could do. No, Tana, no, how did you actually? I am kind of curious how you could have lost 20, because that based on that last game, you should not have lost 20 to Nihal.
Wait, what?
I guess now I know why you lost to Nihal.
Okay. Can you please not check me? Okay, Hikaru, you have 15 seconds in the last.
Okay,
I won't
sure,
ask again.
Sure,
all right,
sure,
last.
Okay,
this is
sure.
It.
Okay, sure. Yeah, let me rematch you. Okay.
Oh man, Chad, I will win this. I promise.
For 1 second. I'm saying, like, I don't know how you could have lost Nihal with 10 seconds. I really don't know how you could have lost him. So I might be willing to try that. I might be willing to try that after this game.
Rematch declined, it said, okay.
Oh, no, I challenge. Okay, there. Yeah, so just make your first move. I make one move and then I let my time run down.
Okay.
Okay. Just go ahead. Wait. Oh, wait. No, it's 50, not 20. Sorry. Okay.
That's cool.
Sure.
What's your idea? You want to mate me? What is this, Bishop man? Only 5 seconds. Why can't I move it? Oh, it's pinned.
Okay.
You want to try the last one with only 10 seconds?
Okay, sure. We'll try one more with 10 seconds. Yeah, one last with 10
seconds. Last with 10 seconds. That's it.
Yeah, I think after the move, it'll get down. Yeah, go ahead. Okay. It should be reset to 10. Should set it to 10. Let's see. Okay. I don't know. Okay, there we go. Wait. Set. Oh, wait. No.
They changed my time to 10 seconds.
Time.
Are you crazy?
No, it's supposed to be my time. It's supposed to be my time. We'll just restart.
You know.
We'll just restart it. Okay. Actually, let me. I should be white in the game. Just 1 second. Okay.
Whoever did this, they just did it for fun. I'm sure.
Yeah. No. Because I was black in the previous game. That's what it was. Okay, let me just make sure I get
sure.
So I'm supposed to be white. Okay. Okay.
Oh, 36,000 people watching. Guys, everybody like the stream, please, man. Definitely drop a like. I promise you,
yeah, chat. Just making sure that I'm white in this game.
This is my game. I promise you. Ye wala main jeeta. Sure. Trust me. You ready?
Should start.
Let's go.
Wait, what time? Okay, there we go. Okay, so they should set it. Okay, go ahead. Okay, clock should be set to 10 seconds. Just 1 second.
Sure, sure. Hmm? Are you going to play Knight F3, yeah?
Maybe.
Okay. Okay, there it goes. Yes. Change this so you can't attack me.
Oh, what's that?
Okay. Let's go with this. Thank you. Oh no. Oh, where do I go? You only 1 second, Hikaru. Ah, what to do? What to do? What to do? No! Look at how much time you had, man. You had 0.001 seconds, man. All right. I accept defeat. The battle has been lost. The war has been won. Oh, man.
Good game.
Humiliation.
You came close.
It's on timeout. All right.
Then I had 0.1. Sorry.
This is so bad. But that was so much fun, man. So thank you so much, Ricardo. For joining, man.
Yeah, no problem. I enjoyed it, and yeah, I'm sure we can do more in the future.
For sure, man. I'm such a big fan, and I was like so nervous to be on the same stream with you. You know, I told you already on the text message. Uh-huh. Like, I admire you so much.
Remind me once again, what was the tweet that I needed to send out?
Yeah, so yeah, the tweet's still there. That whatever you're comfortable in.
Okay. Okay. All right. Okay. Yeah. But I'll make sure to send it out in the next 30 minutes. Sure. Or so, sure. Okay.
Thank you so much for coming, man. It was so sweet of you to join me. And you have so many fans in India, and the content you put is so good. Congratulations on the 1 million subscribers. And I hope you have a great day.
And yeah, thank you. And you'll be there soon too. And nothing but the best. I mean, just keep on what you're doing for chess in India. It's incredible to watch.
I'll be there soon. As in, I'll be 2700.
You'll be there before you get to 2700.
All right.
But maybe one day 2700, maybe.
Yeah, man. Thank you so much. Yeah. Take
likewise.
Care. Bye-bye.
All right, have a good one. Bye.
Bye-bye. तो दोस्तों ये थे हिकारू. रुको, मैं आता हूँ तुम्हारे साथ बात करने के लिए. भाई मजा आ गया भाई आज. ओहो हो, हिकारू नाकामुरा के साथ हमने आज कोलैबोरेट किया है. वन ऑफ द लेजेंड्स ऑफ चेस. भाई तुम मेरे शूज में बैठ के देखो. भाई तुम मेरे शूज में आके देखो साला. वहां पे बस लिखना बहुत आसान है भाई. हक दिया, जोक हक दिया. मेरे जूतों में आओ तुम सालों. एक वन ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट ऑफ ऑल टाइम के साथ तुम एक स्ट्रीम पे बैठ के देखो. तुम्हें समझेगा जो तुम्हारा दगदग होता है दिल में. धिक्कार है तुम्हारी जवानी पे चैट. धिक्कार है तुम्हारी जवानी पे. मैं इनके पास आता हूँ. हेलो मेंबर्स. कांग्रेचुलेशंस भाई, नाम रोशन किया है आज लंडन में. भाई नाम रोशन करके आए हो तुम आज. I don't think हम लोग इससे crazy किसी का sub battle कर सकते हैं ना?
नहीं, इससे ऊपर तो कोई नहीं है.
भाई मजा ही आ गया भाई आज. Congratulations to all of you.
मैं अपने word पे था.
Thank you भाई.
अरे भाई, I know भाई. मैं तुम्हें तो पता ही है. तो मैं कभी ban करता हूँ क्या असली में तुम्हें?
अरे नहीं, मैं आपको मेरी बात कर रहा हूँ भाई. मैं
तुमने kill किया भाई. Kill किया. बहुत लोगों ने kill किया भाई. बहुत मजा आया. But तुम लोग मेरे को भाई ban मत करना बस भाई. Sorry यार. मैंने पूरी कोशिश करी थी यार. Restarts.
आ भाई अच्छा खेला.
साले वैलिडेशन दे ले रहा था मैं तेरे से. मैं पूछ रहा था. अरे अच्छा खेला. कंसोल क्या कर रहा है भाई? बढ़िया. थैंक यू सो मच.
मैं क्रेजी सब बैटल मेरे साथ कर सकते हो भाई.
हां, इसके बाद 20 स्टार्ट का सब करेंगे. डन है भाई. डन है 20 स्टार्ट.
भी खेलूंगा सब बैटल. मैं 20 स्टार्ट की तरफ से खेलूंगा.
मैं भी 20 स्टार्ट की तरफ.
भाई तुम सब भाई इन सबको इसी बीच में रखना. इन सबको इसी बीच में रखना. 20 स्टार्ट स्ट्रीम के बाद मैं आता हूं. आफ्टर पार्टी करते हैं. ठीक है.
बढ़िया.
अरे थैंक
बैन समझ रहा है चैट में. दिखा रहा है तुम्हारी जवानी पे चैट.
ऑलराइट समय कैन यू रेड अरे भाई थोड़ा दो सेकंड आराम तो लेने दो भाई दो सेकंड की आराम की सांस तो लेने दो बंदे को यार या मेंबर्स विल गिव यू मोटिवेशन नाउ नोवा किंग भाई हिकारु वर्सेस हकारु भाई मजा आया कि नहीं चल अगर मजा आया तो लाइक मार दीजिए भाई आई लाइक हिकारु इज सच अ स्वीट गाय ही इज सच अ चिल गाय ब्रो मतलब एकदम चिल में बात कर रहा था ही वाज लाइक टॉकिंग टू मी एज इफ आई एम आल्सो लाइक यू नो हिज कंटेम्पररी इन चेस लाइक एकदम दोस्त की तरह बात किया मेरे को बहुत मजा आया तो आई एम श्योर वी विल कीप ग्रोइंग एज अ कम्युनिटी वी विल रीच मोर मोर हाइट्स एंड वी विल डू मेनी मोर सब बैटल्स और बहुत सारे कोलैब्स करेंगे हम लोग इंटरनेशनल लोगों के साथ अपने देश में बहुत सारे लोगों के साथ तो आप बने रहिए और अगर आप यहाँ पे नए हैं तो आप सब्सक्राइब मार दीजिए बिकॉज हम लोग यहाँ पे चेस करते रहते हैं बकचोदी करते हैं अगर आपको चेस नहीं पसंद तो आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड यू वांट टू बी हियर बट दैट्स कूल ऑलराइट गाइस बाय बाय विद दैट टेक केयर गुड नाइट सी यू ऑल बोल बैंड मैं तुम्हें क्या लगा